Well, it's a little windy. I've got the wind feature on this camera on. We'll see how it works. I'm going to go digging for some snapper. Figured I'm going to dig out my old Snapper Red Comet and see if it starts. It has not been started in... Well, we've been here 5 years. So, ten years this thing hasn't been fired up. And all I'm going to do is check the oil, make sure there's some in there, put some fresh gas in, and see what it does. It's never let me down before, but then again, I've never let it sit so long either. Got to do some digging, so I'll get back to you later. Well, did some digging and camera hog. Hey, Jen. She's got to see everything new. She hasn't seen this at all, probably. Lots of smells, eh? Come on, get out of the way, piggy. Well, there's a couple of old relics I've got stuffed away here. Got my old snapper, which I think is either early 70s, late 60s, if I recall. It's been around for a while. And then this old 50s, I can't remember what the hell that was all about. It's from the 50s. I gotta yank it out to get the snapper out anyway. I should do a video on that thing and try to get it running. It's a neat little relic. What are you digging at? I don't know, you can smell the squirrels. Here's my old snapper. I'm gonna have to clean out all the squirrel debris before I even think about firing this thing up. This thing hasn't been fired up for almost a decade. It'll be interesting. I took the deck off it God knows how long ago. And was using it just as a little property putter. And I'm going to pop some air in the tires so I can roll it a little easier. Well, put some air in the tires. Push it over to the front of the shop here. I've had this thing at least 15, 16 years. I had one property we had, I accidentally took it into the river and flipped it over, fired it up, backed it out of the river and finished doing the lawn. Tougher than nails, I tell ya. We'll see. If it'll even fire up at all. Blow out all that squirrel turd and crap. And go from there. That's it. I'm just going to check to see if there's oil in it. Just going to put some gas in it. I'm going to try to fire it up. I'm not really going to put too much effort into it. I'm just curious. Curious! So I'll get back to you shortly. Hey. That's all I've done really is lubed up, you know, some parts that haven't been moving for a while. The throttle linkage. The throttle linkage was rather immobile, but I've freed it up. And I just sprayed up some of the linkages and everything like that. I probably should at least take the air filter cover off and see if there's anything living in there. But as I say, I'm keeping it down to, let's just see if the bugger will start after almost a decade. I did top it up a little bit with oil, and I think if the date code serves me right, that would mean it's a 78. I'm not sure, I can't really see it all. I think it'll come out really nicely when I edit it. And what I'll do is I'll screw around with the contrast and try to get these numbers out better. I'm pretty sure it was like the first two were the year and then the month and factory code. I don't know, I can't remember on these Briggs and Strattons. But yeah, possibly a 78. We toss some gas in there, set up a tripod, and see if we get any action out of this puppy. Well, got some gas in here, and let's see if she's gonna start, or even turn over. Oh, good start. Turns over. Come on, Betsy. Oh, I got fuel leaking out. Just the throttle's not adjusting any. It's either full or not. yeah. So that was alright. After almost 10 years, the bugger fires up and it moves. Pretty damn good too. Almost wiped it out over there. I don't know if you were in, I don't know if I was in camera or not, but right on. That old bugger's never let me down.